God bless you. Thank you for being with us today. We are Abundant Grace Church. I'm Bishop Ramon DeMaria, and I'm the senior pastor of the church. For prayer or information concerning our ministry, please email me at abundant.grace@att.net. My message title today is The Greatest Election. I will be reading from the book of Isaiah, chapter 55 and verse 11, from the King James Version. So shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper those whereto I sent it. The God's Word Version renders it, my word which comes from my mouth is like the rain and snow. It will not come back to me without results. It will accomplish whatever I want and achieve whatever I send it to do. My beloved, in our nation, we had an election in 2020, November of 2020, to elect a president. There was so much chaos and underhanding things involved in the election. This is the way things are run in the world, but not in the kingdom of God. Evil people are elected to office by evil people with evil motives, but that is not so with God. Human elections are not sure, but the election by God is sure. Humans chosen by voting to hold a certain office have a term limit, but the election by God is eternal. Are you getting the point I'm trying to stress upon right now? The things done by humanity pass away, but the things done by God are eternal. And let me say this, humans make mistakes, but with God, there are no mistakes. So this message is going to deal with God's plan of eternal election and man's plan and temporal election. God's election is eternal and man's election is temporal. God's election is his decree and happens because of his free love, grace, and mercy. And through these elements, he chooses men to faith, holiness, and eternal life for his praise and his glory. The elements of his eternal election were no other but his mere good will and pleasure. In the end, eternal election is a manifestation of the riches of God's grace and mercy. God has chosen his elect to be his adopted sons, to sanctification of life here and eternal life thereafter in the life to come. So in essence, if you are not in Christ, you will not have eternal life in heaven, but will be separated from God in torment. Let's put it this way. Let's get more personal. In the lake of fire for eternity. A person may come to know in time he or she was elected before time, as before the foundation of the world. We come to apprehend this by faith, by our effectual calling, by our justification, by our sanctification, and by the testimony of the Holy Spirit. The divine election of God is his eternal decree, and nothing or no one can ever change it, no matter what they say or do. It is set in stone. It can never be changed. Let me say this. When you die in Christ, you go to heaven, that will never change. When you die outside of Christ and you go to hell, the lake of fire, that will never change. It's eternal. When God calls you, he elects you, it is for eternity. When he does it, that is for eternity. It is God's choice because he is divine. He is supreme over all creation. The sun, the moon, the stars, the planets, everything created is obedient to him because he set these things in place, not man. So God is eternal. You cannot change the mind of God. What he has set to be will be. You know, there's going to be some that won't agree with me concerning this subject, but that does not make it untrue. Remember that God is sovereign over all creation, and he has the right to do whatever he chooses to do. He had a right to choose to save me or to cast me away. He is supreme over everything. Thank God that he chose me. In human elections, men and women sway the thinking of men and women in order to get votes. But with God, this is totally impossible. You cannot bribe God. You may bribe a judge, an elected official, but you cannot bribe God. My beloved, please listen to the whole message. Check out what the Word of God says. Read the scriptures that I give and pray for revelation through the Holy Spirit. As the Holy Spirit speaks to you through the Word of God, you will know the truth. And the truth will set you free from all doubt about election. My beloved, I believe in predestination and election and follow the teachings of John Calvin. I do not believe in Arminian theology, period. So my beloved, our opening verse says it all. God gives explicit details as to his election, but people don't want to accept these details because a lot of times they don't understand, but a lot of times they don't want to understand. They don't want to receive what God has to say. In Isaiah 55 and 10, it says, "For as the rain cometh down, and the snow from heaven, and returneth not thither, but watereth the earth, and maketh it bring forth and bud, that it may give seed to the sower, and bread to the eater." God provides. A lot of people complain when it rains. A lot of people complain when it snows. A lot of people complain when the sky is overcast. They don't look at the benefits of what God allows to happen. They complain about the heat, the sun that promotes photosynthesis, so your flowers bloom and the crops grow. There are those that will complain about everything. If they win the lottery and get $1 million, they will complain that they didn't get $2 million or $3 million. People will complain about everything. When people are hungry and somebody brings them food, they will complain about the food that is brought to them to nourish them. People complain about everything. My beloved, when God gives you something, receive it with gratitude and grace. And thank him for meeting your need. So my beloved, it talks about, "For as the rain cometh down and the snow from heaven and returneth not thither." Rain and snow come down from the clouds in the heavens and do not return again until they have done what they are sent to do or have produced the following effects. Otherwise, they will be exalted into vapors as they often are and drawn up again by the sun. If you look at the vapor on the lake in the early morning, but when the sun comes out, it is drawn back up. The clouds receive their moisture through different reactions in the atmosphere, and that allows the rain to come, the snow to come, the hail to come, the freshness of the air to come. The night comes to cool the earth. The stars shine at night to lead you. The moon at night to lead you and guide you, to be that light. God has a reason for everything that happens, but a lot of people will not look at it from that standpoint. It says, "But waters the earth and maketh it bring forth and bud," or inebriate the earth, water the earth, soak into it. You know, the greatest rains are the soft rains that come down and sink into the earth and go down to the water table and allows your flowers and your grass to continue to feed off of that until the next rain comes. Heavy rains run off. They run off, then they run down the street, and they go into the sewer drains and go out to the lakes to fill the lakes. Then the lakes are emptied by the water pumps that pump it into the cities, into the towers, and is cleaned up and refreshed for you to drink. My beloved, there is a purpose. There's a reason for everything that God allows to happen on this planet. So my beloved, without the rain, we will not have plants to grow. Without the sun, we won't have plants to grow. Without the sun, we won't get our vitamin D. Without the sun, we won't get nourishment. So my beloved, God has a reason for everything. So people should quit complaining. Whether it's raining, snowing, the sun's out, the moon's out, the night comes, the day ends, the freshness comes in the morning, the dew on the grass comes. Quit complaining and receive the blessings of God. It says, but waters the earth and maketh it bring forth and bud. I'm going to repeat that. God has a reason for everything that is happening. My beloved, have you noticed that one rainfall for 15, 20 minutes will turn everything green? And you can get your hose out there and water, or your sprinkler system, whatever, and you got to use a lot more water to allow it to grow and to stay green. But the natural elements that come from the rain, from the natural rain, the natural watering, allows everything to be fed correctly with the proper minerals. So my beloved, don't complain about God allowing things to happen for the good of mankind. It says that it may give seed to the sower and bread to the eater. It will produce a sufficiency of food both for man and animals and beasts, and enough for seed to grow in the ground for the following year. You have to turn over the soil, and it irrigate the soil, and it replenishes the earth. God allows things to happen for a reason. Mm-hmm. They take the seeds, and there's a process that it goes through. So you have seeds for next year. Where do you think the seeds come from? They come from what has been harvested. Okay? So quit fooling around with God's nature. Quit rejecting what God wants to do to the earth. You have no control over what God wants to do. Accept what God has for you. Accept His election. Accept Him choosing you. Accept that He chooses others and He does not choose others, because you have no control over what God has planned from before the creation of the world. That is where I'm going to stop today. That will be part one. Next week, we will pick up with part two of the message series, The Greatest Election. The difference between God's election and man's election. God's election is permanent. Man's election is temporal. But know this, God has control over eternal election and temporal election. And as we go through this message, you will see that that fact is true. And my beloved, I don't know who was chosen or who was elected and who isn't. All I am compelled to do is offer you the opportunity to receive Jesus Christ as your Savior and Lord. And you have the choice as to whether you want to accept that calling or not. If you want to, I want to lead you in a prayer. It's called a prayer of repentance and salvation. And if you would like to receive Christ as your Savior and Lord, please pray this prayer with me and mean it from your heart. As I said, I don't know if you are part of the elect, part of the chosen. I am required to offer you the opportunity. Many will not accept that and will not be part of the elected today. But I don't know about down the road. All I know is that I am offering you the opportunity to receive Jesus Christ as your Savior and Lord and become part of God's chosen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name, I heard the message today, and it really touched my heart. And I don't know whether I am part of the elect or not, but I want to make sure today, by repenting and accepting Jesus Christ as my Savior and Lord. I am sorry for my sins. I repent of my sins. I promise to turn away from my sinfulness. I believe that Jesus Christ is the Savior of all mankind. He is the Son of God. He is the Word that became flesh. He was born, crucified, died, buried, and rose from the dead on the third day, and ascended into heaven, and is now sitting at the right hand of God the Father, from where He shall come to judge the dead and the living. I believe this today. So therefore, I am repenting and asking Jesus Christ to be my Savior and Lord. And I believe by faith that through my repentance and asking Jesus Christ to be my Savior and Lord, I have become part of the elect. And when I go from this life to the next, I will be in heaven with God for eternity. And I thank you for my salvation today. In Jesus' name I pray and thank you. Amen. My beloved, if you said that prayer today, let me be the first to welcome you into the kingdom of God. Now, what I want you to do is go to a Bible preaching, teaching church. Get an audience with a pastor or one of his staff ministers. Tell them what happened. Ask them to pray with you, to pray for you, to anoint you with oil, and to baptize you by full immersion in water in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Ask them to mentor you, to teach you, to lead you and guide you in your newfound faith in Jesus Christ. Then what I would like you to do is email me at abundant.grace@att.net. You can also contact us through our website at www.abundantgracechurch.net or www.abundantgraceofmidlothian.com. So my beloved, please let me hear from you. Once again, our message title has been The Greatest Election from the book of Isaiah, chapter 55 and verse 11. This has been part one. Next week will be part two. So please watch us next week on YouTube. You can listen to our audio portion on Facebook, Twitter, or on different social media sites. So please follow us. I'm Bishop Ramon DeMaria. I'm the senior pastor of Abundant Grace Church. God bless you, my beloved, and go with God.